Yo, what's good YouTube? This is Jay from TNJ, and welcome back to the New Orleans Kings franchise here in the ALCS, where your Kings lead 2-1 over the Chicago White Sox. Now, during this series, it's been really close. Less than two runs each game, that close. And now we put out Forrest Whitley on the mound, one of our top prospects going into this season. And he will face off against Ryan Yarbrough, who's not a hard thrower. He will throw a lot of junk. So we will have our work cut out. Another lefty we're facing for this White Sox team. And let's just hop into the action. Here is Luis Robert leading it off for the White Sox. And he starts it out with a leadoff single. And that's definitely not how we want to start this game with Forrest Whitley on the mound for us, the young pitcher. So that brings up Yandy Diaz hitting 382 here in the playoffs, but a ground ball right back to Whitley. That's an easy double play. And now two runs here in the first, two outs here in the first inning, as that brings up Jose Altuve hitting in the three hole, but he hits one deep to center field. And that one is a no doubter. That's gone. 1-0 White Sox. Good thing we had that double play. Otherwise, that would have been at least a two run homer. And Altuve makes it 1-0 here in game number four. But that brings up Nomar Mazara, who hits a slow roller to second base, and Scooter does come up throwing, and it's going to be the third out of the inning. So that brings up Billy Hamilton to start out the bottom of the first, and he starts it out with a hit as well. So now we got a man on first base here, no outs, and a leadoff single. And let's see what we're thinking. I always want to swipe a bag with Billy Hamilton, so let's see what he does. So that brings up David Bode to the plate. But he swings that one low, and it's going to be a ground ball and an easy double play. Same exact scenario that we had the White Sox in, as that brings up Yasiel Puig to the plate with two outs and a ground ball to third. So the White Sox get out of the first inning with a 1-0 lead. So let's move this one on to the second inning. Here is Jesus Aguilar at the plate now. He hits right into the shift, but Altuve can't field it and throws the first. And Abreu can't field it himself at first base, so it's an error all around. So that brings up Jake Cave to the plate with one out, no outs, actually, and he swings and misses at a low pitch that time, and Yarbrough gets his first strikeout of the game. But that brings up Marcus Semien here with one out, and he's walking, and he's having a tremendous series so far. And now that brings up our young catcher. That's Corey Lee to the plate. But ground ball up the middle. It's a tailor-made double play. But the throw is offline. So now guys on the corners. And that's an error on Mendick at short. And that brings up Scooter, who probably you want up in this situation. But he swings at a curveball. A 71-mile-an-hour curveball, man. And that is strike three. And now it's still 1-0 going into the third. So here is Robert back at the plate. And he hits one down the left field line. I hate when he gets on base because you know he's going to swipe a bag with that 92 speed. And he starts it out with a double. So now a man on second base, no outs. And that's going to be a tapper right back to the mound. Diaz moves him over at least. So now they got a man on third. Altuve comes back to the plate. And it's going to be an outside changeup. And we kind of pitch around Altuve in that at bat. But that brings up Nicholas Castellanos to the plate, their power hitter. He hits one deep to center field, and that one should be deep enough to score Robert from third, and it's going to score him easily. 2-0 here in the third inning. And now let's see if we can get out of this inning with only one run of damage. Mazara comes up, but he hits one hard up the middle. And now Forrest Whitley in a bit of trouble. Now we start to look at our bullpen, because if he gives up one more hit, especially to a red-hot Abreu, we got to pull him. Here is a deep shot to left field, and it's back to the track. And let's see, Clint Frazier jumps up, but it's going to be gone. Three runs here in this inning, four runs here in this inning, and that's a three-run homer by Abreu. And now we start to look at that bullpen. We go and warm up our man Cole Hamels, but back to the at-bat. And it's another hit to the left side. That one gets all the way to the wall, and now we really have to think about pulling him. 59 pitch outing for Forrest Whitley, and we go to the bullpen and we bring in Cole Hamels. And in the regular season, this is his first postseason appearance actually. And in the regular season, he went 3-3, 1.62 WHIP. I mean, wasn't great, but obviously was just a fill-in starter for Jose Lopez. But he does get out of this inning with a strikeout, so at least he does that. And he does have to continue on here in the fourth inning, here facing Mendick, the shortstop. But he's walking him, and they have scored in every single inning so far. Let's not keep that streak going. Up comes Altuve, and he hits one hard up the middle, and Mendick with that 80 speed will get to third. And look at this. Billy Hamilton just takes his sweet time, does not charge the ball at all, and Altuve gets to second. So that's some lazy fielding that time by Billy Hamilton, as it brings up Nicholas Castellanos, who hits one deep to left field. That one makes it to the track and off the wall, and that one will score two runs. And it is a 7-0 lead here in Game 4. It looks like the White Sox have tying this series up on their mind. And that brings up Mazzara, and he hits one hard to the right side with two outs. And we get out of this inning, but where is our offense? It's 7-0. We're going to need it. So that brings up Aguilar to the plate to start out the fourth inning. And he hits one to the left side, and that is going to be away from the shifter. They were hugging the bag on that one. As now that brings up Jake Cave to the plate. After a pass ball, Aguilar gets to second, and he walks, though. So it doesn't really matter now. Guys on first and second. Simeon, he walks as well, his second walk of the game. So bases loaded here. Corey Lee, no outs. We have to capitalize on this situation. Yarbrough, low pitch. And Corey Lee goes and gets it, and it's going to be deep and off the wall and left. And let's see, we're going to send the runner from first base all the way home, and it's going to be a perfect throw from the relay man. Marcus Simeon is thrown out at home. Maybe we should have stayed at third. There still would have been no outs in this inning. That brings up Scooter, who goes deep to left center, and that one will make it to the gap. And Corey Lee was sitting there tagging up, but he's going to score. He's got 75 speed. It's all good. But still a 7-3 game. It should have been a 7-4 game. But one out here in the inning with Scooter in scoring position. So now close to the lineup rolling over. Here's Clint Frazier at the plate, but he's going to swing and miss at that one. And now two outs in the inning. Billy Hamilton comes back to the plate, and he grounds out to first, but at least we get three back. We still have a lot of baseball left here in this game. But on to the top of the fifth inning. Here is Zach Collins at the plate, still facing Cole Hamels. He hits one to the left side, and that one does get over to left field, and that does start them out with a one-out single. And we decide to go to the bullpen earlier instead of keeping Cole Hamels in like we did with Forrest Whitley. We bring in Joe Smith, last year's closer, but his first batter he faces hit up the middle. They are just on fire on offense. And now guys on first and second here, now two outs in the inning, and that's Luis Robert at the plate, and he hits one to the right side, and Aguilar can't field it. And that gets through to Puig in right field, and that is going to be another run scored, 8-3. So now guys on second and third here, and this is Yandy Diaz, who hits one to right center. That one gets to the wall. It's now 10-3 here in the ALCS Game 4, and the White Sox are just hot on offense. We did not expect this. So that brings up Jose Altuve, who has been absolutely hot at the plate. And he goes to the exact same spot, right to right center, and another run scored. We should have pulled Joe Smith there, and now we don't. 11-3 here in the fifth inning. Wow. So now we do finally pull him, pulling in Chris Davinsky out of the bullpen. He's only appeared in two games, only three innings pitched, but we need something. Here's Nicholas Castellanos at the plate, and he does just fly out to center field, but 11-3 here. They have scored in every single inning this game so far. As we already just moved this one onto the ninth inning, we just don't have enough firepower in this one. Simeon up at the plate, he grounds out, and that one will tie this series up at 2 apiece. With one more home game left for the Kings, we definitely need to win this next game, because if we go down 3-2 back to Chicago, it's going to be tough. But the road teams have won every single game here in this series. So going into Game 5, I'm going to throw out Alex Wood. I think it's a must-win game here, and I think that we need this game in order to swing momentum back in our favor, because Chicago has all the momentum at this point, especially with that big offensive output they had in the last game. So let's kick off Game 5. Here is Alex Wood on the mound, and he's already given up a hit to Jose Peraza at the plate. And wow, I mean, This team is just hot. Even Peraza had the day off yesterday. He only hits first lefties. So that brings up Diaz in the two hole. Up the middle. Another hit. So guys on first and second, their offensive firepower continues here in game five. So that brings up Jose Altuve to the plate. And he's watching one low and outside. It's ball four. Bases loaded. No outs here in the first inning. So that brings up Nicholas Castellanos, who hits one hard to the left side, and that one will get down. And that is Jake Cave playing in left field today. He fields it awkwardly, and it hits off his body. It's 1-0 here for the White Sox. Still no outs with the red-hot Jose Abreu coming up, who's been hot in this series. And he does get him to strikeout looking. And Luis Robert hitting in the sixth hole. This game comes up. Ground ball to second. And let's see, we go to two, and we don't tag the runner. Instead, we go to second, and Simeon holds it because that 92 speed, Luis Robert would have beat that one out. And instead, now it's a 2-0 game. That brings up Mazzara, but ground ball to short. And at least we only get two out of that inning. Man, they had bases loaded, no outs. So now let's move on to the bottom of the third inning because our offense is just going cold. But here's Scooter at the plate. He hits one deep to right field, and it will make it to the wall in right center, and it's going to bounce off the wall. And that's going to be a leadoff double here for the Kings here in the third inning. As we move on here, Corey Lee up to the plate. And he's swinging at one on the outside half of the plate. And Dylan Cease, who's actually their number five spot starter, he does have five strikeouts here in the first three innings. But he does walk Reese McGuire there as that brings up Billy Hamilton as his lineup rolls over. Let's see what he can do. He gets hit by a pitch. Okay, so now we're in business. Bases loaded with David Bodie, who led our team in average in the regular season. Let's see what he does. He strikes out swinging on the low slider. And I think the one thing about Dylan Cease, he has a 99-mile-an-hour fastball and a slider that just drops off. But there Puig comes up and swings and misses. Bases loaded, and we don't get any runs. We only have one hit through the first three innings. As now we move on to the top of the fourth. Here is Luis Robert, who has been killing so far in this series. He hits one to the left side, and that is going to be a hit. Man, is he hot. So Nomar Mazzara comes to the plate here, hitting in the seven hole today. Ground ball to second, and Scooter, it gets by him, and it gets to center, and Billy Hamilton comes up throwing to the cutoff man. But we need a ground ball here with Zach Collins up to the plate. Let's get a double play ball. He hits one to right field, but you know Robert with 92 speed, he's tagging on this one. Puig comes up throwing, and the throw is nowhere near home plate. It's 3-0 here in game number five. So Mendek comes up to the plate. And he hits one hard. That one gets to center. Billy Hamilton comes up throwing. But at least we hold the runners at first and second here. But Jose Peraza, the lineup rolls over. Ground ball to second. Scooter fields it. Throws the first. It's 3-0 here through the first four innings. And let's see what our offense can do. So here's Jake Cave up at the plate. He leads it off for us with one out. And he hits one hard. And that's deep. And it's going to be gone. That's a home run. Jake Cave. Man, this guy is hot. He is a power bat in our lineup. And really, he's exactly what we've needed here. A little spark here for our offense. So now Marcus Simeon comes up to the plate here, hitting in the sixth hole. He hits one right up the middle, but the shift is on. So that's an easy ground ball. As two outs here in the inning, Scooter Jeanette up to the plate. Let's see what he can do. He's one for one. And they will not risk it. They just hit him with the pitch. And now a man on first base here with two outs, Corey Lee. Keep the inning going, fella. But he just hits a fly ball here in the infield. Altuve is under that one. And now it's 3-1 going to, that's actually Jose Peraza, I should say. So now we go into the middle innings. Luke O'Connor comes out of the bullpen. And now with a man on first base, Jose Altuve at the plate. Fly ball to center field. I mean, we have not been able to get anybody out. So let's see what Luke O'Connor can do. We're going to need him to pitch some pretty good innings here. As now that brings up the red-hot Jose Abreu. And on a 2-1 count, he hits one deep to right field. And it does get off the wall and right. Puig fields it and comes up throwing to the cutoff man. but we will hold the runner at third base. So now guys on second and third here, two outs, and Luis Robert comes up. It hits one hard to the left side, and that one will be another run scored for the White Sox here in the last two games. I mean, man, they are just red hot. As we do pull O'Connor and we bring in Craig Stammen out of the bullpen, I mean, this is just ridiculous. And now with bases loaded, he does walk a guy, but a ground ball to first. And we get out of that inning, but the White Sox stretch the lead out 4-1. So that brings up Reese McGuire here in the fifth inning. He's going to hit one to center field. And there we go. At least we get a leadoff single here in the fifth. We got some catching up to do. Billy Hamilton at the plate. He's watching an inside curveball. So here we go. This could be our run. So guys on first and second here, David Bodie comes up. And it's going to be a fly ball to right field, but we will tag the runner from second. And with 35 speed, we will make it just in time. And that one will put us at guys on the corners here. Yasiel Puig to the plate. At least the middle of our lineup's up. But he hits just a soft ground ball. And that's an easy double play. So, man, the White Sox are scoring runs. We are failing to score runs. And now we move on to the sixth inning with a man on first base. Craig Stammen gives up a hit to the right side. And it's going to make it all the way to the gap. And Billy Hamilton comes up throwing to the cutoff man. But now guys on first and second here. And Nicholas Castellanos at the plate. One for three in this game. He goes to opposite field. Another run. It's 5-1 here in game number five. And now they still keep this inning going. Jose Abreu at the plate. But he does just hit a fly ball to center field. But 5-1. This is not looking good here for the New Orleans Kings. So that brings up Corey Lee to the plate. He hits one to the left side in the sixth inning, and that was with the guy on third base and another out. Here in the seventh inning, one out. Here is David Bodie at the plate. And he swings and misses on the curveball. So now we are up to the eighth inning. Can we get anything going? Jesus Aguilar is swinging and missing, and that brings up Jake Cave, who scored the only run in this game. And let's see if he can keep it going. Fly ball to center field. Our offense has just went cold as we move on to the bottom of the ninth inning. Here is Scooter Gennett. This is our last chance. And he does start us out with a leadoff walk here. It's now 5-2. As now that brings up Corey Lee to the plate. Let's see what he does. He hits one deep to left field. It's got carry. And the left fielder is on the track. And it will be run down. And that one sucks. That one could have brought it to a one-run game as they go to their bullpen, bringing in Jimmy Cordero. Remember the last time we faced him, it was three straight choppers right back to the mound. So Reese McGuire comes up to the plate, and he walks. He actually got the start at catcher, and we move Corey Lee to the DH spot as that brings up Billy Hamilton, and he hits a ground ball to second, and they will go to second base on that one. But at least we do continue this inning. Now with two outs, David Bodie could tie this game up with one swing of the bat. But he does swing at some high heat, 99 mile an hour. And wow, we drop three straight at home. The road team has won every game in this series, 5-2 for the White Sox. And now we have to go back to Chicago for two straight games, and we are facing elimination. 5-2 here in this game. They had 14 hits, and it's just the top of their lineup is just tearing the cover off the ball. Luis Robert, Castellanos, I mean, man, I don't know if we're gonna make it, but we are gonna put up a fight here in game six. I mean, if we have something to say about it, we have to. And now let's see what this team is made of. Game six coming next. Hit subscribe, hit that like button. Stay tuned. Let's get it. Let's go. Yeah, hey, filling out these job applications. Life got hard after high school graduation. I went to college and your boy got financial aid. They gave me money, then I went and bought a pair of J's. And I bought a pair of shades. And I bought a new computer. Half $400 left, spent the rest on